Meeting your season goal comes with higher rewards.
The kicking team here for the extra point. Oh, and now they're going to fake it. It's a wobbler and it's intercepted. And this one will be brought back to the 22. Extra point attempt to follow here. Oh, and now they're going to fake it. And he'll be out of bounds well short of the goal line, so the attempt at the fake extra point unsuccessful.
Okay, they went for the fake off of the extra point attempt. It's a long way to go, and they didn't get.
Now for the point after. And he's got it in the end zone. Bit of a surprising call here, down by as many as they are, but the fake works, and they'll get 2 points closer instead of one. The city always a little extra. They start on the ground with McCaffrey. And not much to speak of. Call it a 1 yard gain up to the 15. Here's second and 9, just a yard on that last run. Brown looking to pass, second down. He'll end up getting 5 out of that, but now they're looking at third down. In search of 4 yards here to pick up the first down. Corral here working from the gun. He'll get this out right here to McCaffrey. And he'll get this up past the 25 before he's out of bounds. Give him 6 yards and they do convert on third. Here's Corral on first down. And that'll be knocked away. It's incomplete.
Receiver coaches preach to their guys all the time, separation. That's what's going to make the play successful. That time there was very little, and I think they were actually fortunate that it was only knocked away and not intercepted.
And he'll get a couple up to the 29.
Defensively, we always know that he is deep and run support. And I think the way that he gets there is he understands what an offense is going to do before the ball's even snapped. A great job of scouting prior to the game, then reading, reacting, and taking the right path to the ball carrier.
This defense not budging. Back-to-back carries of just 2 yards. First down throw here for Corral. Oh, this one incomplete. The pressure got to him as he released it. And it's second down. An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. Second and 10, Corral. Throw left side, McCaffrey's got it. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. From Falcon territory now, here's first and 10 at the 46. A throw there, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
Quarterbacks move all the time by manipulating a defense with their eyes and their head movement. In this case, he just stared the receiver down. That allowed for excellent coverage, able to knock that one away.
Corral under pressure, and down he goes. Arnold Ebukadi. Panther football to start quarter number two, as they've got it with a third down and long coming up. Third and long, Corral. Trying to fit it into Moore, but it's intercepted. Picked up by Richie Grant, and the Panthers are going to get this back to their own 34-yard line. Wait a second, they declined the penalty?
I'm as puzzled as you are, partner. I don't understand how any time you lose possession of the ball.
Corral to throw, first and 10. Got his man, Robbie Anderson. And he'll get him down after a pickup of 8, second and 2. Here's a second and 2 now from the 33. On second down, here's Corral. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. But fortunately, a Panther was able to get on this, so Carolina keeps the ball.
Much like a running back going through the line, quarterbacks have to be aware of protecting the football as well. He left it exposed that time. Wound up having it knocked free, but fortunately, had an alert teammate who was
into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off by A.J. Terrell, and the Falcons are going to take possession of the football. Trying to shake off the interception, he'll look to throw. His throw incomplete.
Well, this defense is certainly organized and playing off of each other because the rush is providing pressure and the coverage is forcing incompletions and capitalizing on mistakes. When you get every level on defense hitting at once, you get first half scores just like this one.
They get 7 out of that, so they're left with a 3rd and 3. 2 minutes remaining in this first half of football. Coming up here looking for 3 yards to pick up the first. 3rd down, Corral. Able to complete this to Chenault. And he is going to have a Panthers first down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion. On 1st down, this is McCaffrey. On the move past the 40. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. Good yardage as he rumbles for 24 and a first. First down, here's Corral with it. That'll be caught right side, Chenault with it. And they've got this down to about the 12-yard line.
Well, these guys have definitely been outplayed in the first half. I like their countenance. I like the way that they haven't panicked out there, the way they're carrying themselves. They're starting to move the ball. And what you have to do, maintain your poise and start to put together some drives.
Now a throw to the end zone on first down, but it winds up incomplete. On second and 10, Corral. And it'll be caught in the end zone for the Carolina touchdown by DJ Moore. A 12-yard touchdown grab. And the Panthers get a late score. First down, it's Corral. And too much juice. It'll be out of bounds, incomplete. So another incompletion there. He's hitting on fewer than half his pass attempts in this one, and that is not a winning formula.
Yeah, so let's make sure we give a little bit of credit to the defense here. They've given him a lot to think about, a lot of different looks, and he seems a little bit confused trying to complete passes.
That'll leave him with a third and two coming up. They got 8 yards there. They'll try and pick it up with McCaffrey. And he's going to have the first down at about the 38. Give him the third down conversion, 5 yards on the play. So here's a first and 10 at the 38. They stay on the ground, McCaffrey again. And he will lose yardage back to the 34-yard line. They'll have to deal with a second and 14 now after the loss. A handoff, McCaffrey running right. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. Now a third and long, they'll look to throw. And incomplete on the deep ball. They have not gotten him going at all. Trying to spark something there with a longer throw, unable to complete it.
But you have to keep.
First down. Oh, he'll take a shot from McCaffrey downfield, and that is incomplete. Took a shot there on first down, but he couldn't reel it in. Second and 10, third quarter of the season opener. On second and 10, here's Corral. That's to McCaffrey, complete. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. And the offense moving quickly to the line. Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete. Third quarter on a Monday night with a second and 10 coming up. A give up the middle, Hubbard. And he'll get about three here up to the 44-yard line. This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. He gets this one to Hubbard, complete. And they're going to mark him down short, maybe by about a yard, if that. So the completion good for seven there. And that's going to make it fourth. Here's Corral on first down. And he'll dump this off to his running back, McCaffrey. Brings it up just shy of the 25. Showed some of that quickness there on the move. Throwing again on second down. Corral. And the Falcons get there. The Falcons get the sack. Down he goes. Now after the sack, you got Corral and the Panthers here staring at a tough play. Third and long. A pass complete to Moore. And he'll be corralled well upfield right around the 40-yard line. Corral to throw on first and 10. And this one is incomplete.
When you're leading in the final quarter, your radar has to be up for any potential deep shots. And probably not the last one they're going to see in this game, not as long as they hold this lead.
Now, meanwhile, here's a second down throw. It's knocked away and incomplete. The Panthers on third down, not quite 50%, 4 for 9. This is third and 10. And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked up by Casey Hayward. And the Panthers are right back in this football game. So the holding call on the offense, so they go ahead and decline that one and take possession of the football on the INT. Ball game.
Some true stories to tell. You're back outside, but they still lied. Whoa. Yeah.
Take off the foo-foo. Take off the cloud chase. Take off the Wi-Fi. Take off the money phone. Take off the car loan. Take off the blessing, the white loss. Take off the weird jewelry. I'ma take 10 steps, then I'm taking off top off. Take off some fabricated streams and the microwave memes. It's a real world outside. Take off your idols. Take off the runway. Take off the Cairo. Take off the Sandro pay, 5 days stay, take a quarter meal, hella follow. Take off the far flag, take off perception, take off the cop with the iPad. Take off the allure, take off the unsure, take off decisions I lack.
Pickett to throw on first down. That ball caught by the former Toledo Rocket, Deontay Johnson. And he gets this one inside the 15, just a yard or two shy of the 10. So how about this for field position after the big play? Inside the 15 now as they come up on first and 10. That throw finds Pickens in the end zone. Touchdown, Steelers.
After review of the play, ruling on the field.
So they called it a touchdown originally, and this will stay a touchdown after the video review, so they had it right. And it'll be fourth down. Pickett now to throw off the play fake. Rolling to his right. On the run, he'll let this go deep right side. And that will be incomplete. Would have been a big hitter if they had connected. Instead, it's second down. After the incompletion, here's second and 10 from the 20. Pickett back to throw. And that went too far in front. He couldn't reel it in. It's incomplete.
But so far in this drive, they've done some good work. They force incompletions on first and second down, bring up third and 10. That brings up the big question. Do they bring pressure or do they play coverage on this down?
Throwing on third down. Here's Pickett. And it's out. He put it on the carpet. Now the Seahawks going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. First down. And his throw is going to be incomplete.
I think he's got to be careful not to force anything into coverage right there. There weren't really any throwing lanes, but the best part for him, he's got second and third down to fall back on.
Pickett throwing again on second down. And the Seahawks defense gets to him and they bring him down. They'll get to the line here, but remember, it's also third down. This is Chase Claypool on the receiving end. And he'll be taken down here just shy of the 30. Now a timeout signaled for, and they'll get it with 10 seconds to go before halftime. Harris starts the drive on the ground. He'll be dropped after a gain of about six across the 30 to the 31. The last run got six, now second and four. Pickett sets up play action. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. First catch of the new season for him, and he picks up the first. To the air on first down with Pickett. And he fires one incomplete.
Had the right idea there, trying to throw it to the sideline, but he let him just a little bit too much, trying to get it out to his receiver. Ends up falling to the ground incomplete.
They try to throw on second down, but this one is incomplete.
The goal is certainly to try and make a big play happen and climb back into this game, but you have to be careful. If you overdo it, you could turn it over and hurt your team. I think it's safe to say he's made some questionable decisions out there so far. Force some throws into tight coverage. He's already.
Now a first down carry for Harris. Looking for a seam, but finding none. He'll get back to a line of scrimmage, and that's it. Third quarter of a tight football game as we come up on a second and 10. From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. And his throw is incomplete.
I'll help you out here a little bit, partner, because what I'm seeing is a passing game that's just struggled to complete anything. No rhythm, no timing. Seems like every pass is also contested well. So give some credit to the defense.
And he's got some space here. And he is out of bounds inside the 35. Pittsburgh getting 16 yards there and also a first down.
I'm not sure that was necessarily a safety valve or a check down throw on third down. Sometimes just try and find the open guy and get him the ball. He did exactly that and found a way to pick up a first down.
And he can't find a receiver and he's brought down. They're going to hurry back to the line now to try again after the sack. Pickett, and that is incomplete.
I know conventional wisdom says, hey, don't get it all back in one play, but sometimes you go ahead and try to. They tried to get it all back on that one, weren't able to do so.
Pickett in trouble, and down he goes. Barreling in for the sack, Shelby Harris. Third and long, you knew that he was going to throw it, but he just couldn't find anybody to throw it to.
Yeah, it shouldn't have been. Perfect execution.
On first and 10, it's Pickett. And that one knocked away and incomplete. Nice job defensively on what will be the final play. Back now in Seattle, Washington. After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. From the gun, here's Pickett. And he can't find anywhere to go with it. And he goes down. Pickett and the Steelers in need of a big play here. Third and long after the sack. Throwing there, but this pass is going to wind up incomplete.
How about some applause for the defense there? They forced him to throw that one into coverage, and just like that, they're staring at.
First and 10, here's Pickett. And the coverage terrific there as that's knocked down and incomplete.
Partner, for once in my life, I'll be succinct. In a one-possession game, every single stop like that could be a difference maker.
And he'll get only a couple up to the 22. One of the bigger plays in the game thus far, and the crowd getting into it as we come up on a big third down. Back to throw, Pickett. Quick completion here to Johnson. And he will have a Steelers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
This defense has certainly had an outstanding second half, haven't they? I know they just gave up the first down there for the offense. They're hoping that that's something that they can jumpstart.
Pressure comes. He's taken down by the Seahawks defense. Looking to speed things up here, going with some tempo. And the comeback may stall out. It's intercepted. Picked off by Quadre Diggs. And the Seahawks are going to take possession of the football. Pickett can't get away, and he's taken down. Pickett trying to get his guys up quickly to the line of scrimmage. Pickett to throw. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked off by Jason Verrett, and the Seahawks are going to take over at their own 41. City, always a little extra excitement for.
Space, it would have been a good time for his first carry of the game.
Pickett now from near his own goal line. This one complete to his fullback out of the backfield. 9 yards, not quite enough, and they'll be left now with third and one.
It's pretty easy to overlook the fullback when you're making your assignments defensively in the pass coverage game, but in this case, they made him pay for that oversight and picks up a nice gain.
And able to get this one out just shy of the 25 at the 24. A gain of 10, good for a Steeler first down. The Steelers had 0-1 in the year following the loss in the opener. And listen, they knew last week they were in for a tough fight on the road. But now here's the... Under a heavy rush, and down he goes. So now 20 yards to go on...